So we've been thinking about the meaning of the Passover and how the Lord himself comes to judge. Then we've also seen how the firstborn son takes responsibility for the sins of the household, and that teaches us Jesus is the firstborn over all creation. It says that in Colossians 1. 15 to 20. Jesus is the firstborn over all creation, and therefore, he's the one who must take responsibility for the whole creation, and he's happy to do so, and he's the one who must die for the sins and mess of the whole creation. Yeah, we've seen that. We've meditated on it. But think about this. Why doesn't Jesus in the Gospels give long lectures about the meaning of his death? I mean, the prophets and the apostles spend more time, in a way, talking about the meaning of atonement and sacrifice, and Paul and Peter and the book of Hebrews has lots of deep explanation about the meaning of the death of Jesus. Why doesn't Jesus give those sorts of lectures in the Gospels? He says a little bit about them. You know, he says he's come to give his life as a ransom for many, and at the time when he does the Last Supper, he gives some instruction, but it's comparatively small amount compared to what we find in the prophets of the Old Testament or Moses or the apostles in the New Testament. And sometimes people have wondered about that. If the death of Jesus is this central thing, and a third at least of the gospel stories are just preoccupied with the last few days of the life of Jesus, his death takes up an enormous amount of the gospel accounts. And Jesus is always talking about the fact that he's going to die. That's a very strong thing all the way through his ministry. Why doesn't he give more lectures on the meaning of it? Like, why doesn't he preach some sermons in the Gospels about the meaning of his death? The key to that is understanding how Jesus teaches. Like, Jesus doesn't give, like, theological lectures. We're so used to the idea of theological lectures and things. Whereas Jesus teaches in a much more profound way. So, for example, say something like justification by faith alone. Now, we, since the Reformation especially, you know, whole books and volumes and conferences and seminars and huge lectures trying to explain and get to the heart of this thing, this truth, the idea that we're righteous not on the basis of what we do, but because the living God regards us as righteous because of what Jesus has done. There's enormous quantities written about that trying to explain it. But Jesus, because he's such a brilliant teacher, teaches that better than anyone else in the whole Bible in an incredibly simple way. He just has that story. If you remember, there's this religious guy who goes to the temple to pray, and he thinks he's good, he's righteous, and he's like, Lord God, I thank you that I am not a sinful person like that guy over there. Thank you, Lord, that I'm good, basically. And then there's this other person who's a messed up person, not very religious, his whole life's probably a mess, and he comes to pray to this Lord God and just says, Lord, be merciful to me, a sinner. And then Jesus simply asks the question, which of these two is justified? Which of these two is right with God? And of course, the religious people would go, well, it's the religious guy. He's the good guy. But the correct answer is, it's the sinful person. But you go, well, how can he be right with God? Because he just trusts in God. He just trusts in the Lord Jesus. And all he asks for is mercy. And he goes home justified. Now, in that little tiny story that just takes like two or three verses of the Bible, really, Jesus teaches the doctrine of justification better than anyone else in the whole Bible and in all of history. He gets at it in such a way that anybody and everyone can understand it completely and perfectly. So in a similar way, when he comes to teach about the meaning of his death, actually the biggest way he does it in some of his stories, but in a way, the key to it is that he dies at the time of Passover. He has it so that he dies at the time of Passover, and when he's preparing to go to die, he celebrates the Passover meal with his disciples, and then at that meal, he says, now this bread being broken, that's like me being broken, and this wine, if you drink that, that's like you drinking my blood, my body, my blood. I am the Passover lamb, and that that is the explanation for what's about to happen to me. I'm about to be sacrificed as the Passover lamb, and it is my blood that will protect you from the judgment of God. Like, on the day of judgment, when God comes to pass judgment on the whole world, you need to have my blood on you, and he calls it the blood of the covenant. If you have my blood upon you, the judgment will pass over you. Jesus makes all that clear mainly by dying at the time of Passover. He doesn't need to give huge lectures. The truth of the Passover in Exodus is really the best possible explanation of Jesus' death. If we want to have Jesus's in-depth explanation of the meaning of his death, he's really saying, get my in-depth explanation from the book of Exodus. Go and learn the meaning of the Passover, and then you will understand the true meaning of my death. And so with that in mind, that's why we're spending time teasing out carefully the meaning of the Passover as it's recorded for us in the book of Exodus. Because effectively, Jesus in the Gospels is saying, if you want to really understand my death, go and study the book of Exodus, and especially the Passover.